We thank the Lord for bringing us together once again in His presence. David said, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. As you are here today, I can assure you, you are in the right place. You are in the right place. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Heavenly Father, I thank you for the service today. Heavenly Father, I thank you for your children who have gathered in your house today. Father, I thank you for your presence in the house today. Father, I thank you for your anointing in the house today. Father, I thank you that the atmosphere, it saturated in the anointing of the Holy Ghost. Father, as your word is coming forth, let the word touch lives and transform life. Father, I pray for understanding of your word in the mighty name of Jesus. Let every heart receive the word. Let every ear hear the word. And let every mind receive the word. Let it fall on solid ground. And let the word bear fruit in their lives. In the mighty name of Jesus. Heavenly Father, we vow to give you all the glory. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen and amen. Learn to serve. Learn to serve. Today we are going to learn something about serving. Serving in the house and serving others. Serving in the house and serving others. Learn to serve. Let's look at something in Matthew chapter 20, verse 26 to 28.
Matthew 20, 26. But it shall not be so among you, but whatsoever will be great among you, let him be your minister. Verse 27, and whosoever will be chief among you, let him be your servant. 28, even as the Son of Man came not to be ministered unto, but to minister and to give his life a ransom for many. Amen.
Hallelujah. Learn to serve. This is our Lord Jesus Christ speaking here to the disciples. The importance of serving. Serving in the house and serving one another. Jesus was a perfect example of a servant. Even though he's a son of God, he humbled himself and brought himself at the level of man. And he gave his life as a ransom for many. And I want you to understand something, that we have to come to the place of getting rid of the me first attitude. Everything me. But right now, we should be serving, giving ourselves for the kingdom and for others. As we grow in Christ, we should serve one another. Because one thing you must realize, that the humble you are is the lifting up you will be. The low you are is the height you will be. The small you are is the great you will be. The obedient you are is the ruler you will be. And the servant you are is the king you will be. So serving one another . The more that you serve, the more you realize that you are being lifted up to a level in life. People must see you as a servant, but God sees you as a king. So learn to serve. Jesus was a servant, and yet a leader. Matthew 20, let's look at 28 and 29. The same chapter. Matthew 20, 28 and 29.
Matthew 20, 28. Even as the Son of Man came not to be ministered unto, but to minister and to give his life a ransom for many. Verse 29. And as they departed from Jericho, a great multitude followed him.
Hallelujah. Now, Jesus, he was a servant. He came to serve. He came to minister to others. But yet, multitude followed him. The humble he was, the higher he became. The servant he was, the king he became. He was a servant, but yet a leader. The Bible says that a multitude followed him. Imagine, a multitude followed a servant. You are serving others, but yet multitude are following you. You must be an example to others, as Christ is an example unto us. Never complain when you are serving in the house. Never complain when you are serving in the house of God or serving others. Let's look at Hebrews 6:10. Hebrews 6:10.
Hebrews 6, verse 10. For God is not unrighteous to forget your work and labor of love, which ye have showed toward his name, in that ye have ministered to the saints and do minister. Amen.
Hallelujah. He says, for God is not unrighteous to forget your work and labor of love, which ye have showed towards his name, in that ye have ministered to the saints and do minister. God will never forget your love. He will never forget your work and your labor of love unto others. And in his house, be sure that the Lord will bless and promote you and exalt you in due season, as you learn to serve. Church, learn to serve one another. Learn to serve one another. Let's look at 1 Corinthians 15:58. First Corinthians 15:58.
1 Corinthians 15:58. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. For as much as ye know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. Amen.
Hallelujah. The Bible says that, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. For as much as ye know that your labor in the Lord is not in vain. Your service in the Lord is not in vain. Serving in the house is not in vain. Serving others is not in vain. I remember in Luke chapter 7, there was this centurion. The Bible says that his servant, who was dear to him, was sick and at the point of death. And he heard that Jesus was in town. So he sent some men to go and call Jesus. The Bible says that when they went to Jesus, they said, Master, the centurion is worthy of this because he loved the nation, he loved us, and he has built a church for us. As soon as they said that, Jesus got up and said, let's go. The man's service to the saints caused Jesus to rise up and go with them. Whatever you are doing for God is recorded in heaven. And when the time comes, whatever the need may be, it will be remembered before God. And the answer will come speedily. So your service is not in vain. As a child of God, let's serve one another in any capacity. It doesn't have to be preaching or singing. It could be anything that you do for your sister, for your brother, for the kingdom. It's recorded in heaven. So let's serve one another in the name of Jesus. I remember another story of a woman in Acts chapter 9. The Bible says that this woman was full of good works and alms deed. She was serving the saints, doing good things. But one day, she fell sick and died. Now, because of the good things she did, because of her service to the saints, they said, she must be resurrected because of the good things that she has done. And they sent for Peter. When Peter came, they showed Peter all the good things that she has done for the kingdom and for the saints. As soon as Peter saw what she has done, the Bible says that Peter went on his knees instantly and said, God, she must be resurrected. The Bible says that Peter prayed and the woman got up. As a result of her service in the body, as a result of serving one another, she could not go just like that. So church, whatever we are doing, remember, it is recorded. The Bible says that, do not be weary in well-doing. Don't be tired of doing good. Don't be tired of helping one another. The Bible says that in due season, you will reap if you don't give up. Hallelujah. So let's keep on serving one another. Let's keep on doing good in any capacity that we can, in any ability that we can, in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Now, I want us to follow the example and learn from our Lord Jesus. The way he humbled himself and the way he served. Philippians chapter 2. Let's look at verse 5 to 9. Philippians 2. 5 to 9.
Philippians 2, 5. Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus, who, being in the form of God, thought it not robbery to be equal with God. Verse 7, but made himself of no reputation, and took upon him the form of a servant, and was made in the likeness of men. And being found in fashion as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even the death of the cross. Verse 9, wherefore God also had highly exalted him and given him a name which is above every name. Amen.
Hallelujah. You see, the Bible says that Jesus humbled himself. He put aside, though he's the Son of God, he put aside everything and made himself a servant. He served. And Bible says that because he humbled himself and learned obedience through the suffering, God exalted him. God lifted him up and gave him a name that is above every other name. You see how serving can do to a man's life. People might not value what you are doing, but God values it. You might be sweeping the floor, cleaning toilets. People look down on you. But God sees how far your service will take you. If you don't get tired of serving, if you don't get tired of doing good. So I want to encourage one another that we should learn to serve in the kingdom. We should learn to serve one another. Because serving, I believe that takes you closer to your destiny. I remember many years ago, when I became born again, in the Apostolic Church. And for some reason, I fell in love. I just want to do things for the man of God, the pastor. And I will always go to his house, clean, wash his car, mow the lawn, do things for him. Because I love doing it. I didn't know that it was pushing me closer to my destiny. Then I found myself from the Apostolic Church in action, doing the same thing. I was serving in the ushering department. And I was in the protocol team. Whenever a man of God comes, I'm the one carry their bike, everything. I was doing it. Then I moved to Liberty. I was serving the pastor. In fact, I was serving him like a houseboy. I was doing everything for this man of God. I was the one, I was always there, doing everything. No not knowing that it was pushing me to my destiny. To me, I enjoy serving. I just want to serve. Then I found myself with this great man of God. You see, I was just serving, but I didn't know that it was pushing me to my destiny. Just serving. Now I find myself here today, preaching. It started as a serving man of God, like a houseboy. What you are doing for God is preparing you for your destiny. It doesn't matter what it is. Do it with all your heart. Serve with all your heart. Let's serve one another. Because as you are serving, it is pushing you to your destiny. And you realize that all the serving that I did over the years has brought me this far. Serving is good. Serving is good. It doesn't matter what you are doing in the house. Serving is good. So I want to encourage you, child of God, keep on serving. Keep on serving one another. Keep on serving one another. Because your service is taking you to your destiny. Whenever the going gets tough, your service will speak for you. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Let's keep on serving. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. 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 In the mighty name of Jesus. I pray that you have been blessed by this message that has brought to you today. Keep on doing what you are doing. Amen. Keep on doing what you are doing. Because our service is going to take us where we should be. As we serve in this house, and as we serve one another, we will see the impact, and we will see the fruit, and we will see what our service can do. Because as many are coming, and as we are serving, and as they see the humility and the humbleness of this house, and when they see the love that we love one another, that we are there for one another, it will make them see that, yes, this is the place. This is the place. This is the place. This is the place. So please, let's walk in love. Let's serve one another in every capacity. In the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen and amen. Amen.
Father, we want to worship and adore you. We want to bless your holy name for all you've done for us, God. We want to say thank you, Lord. Lord, I'm grateful unto you for all you've done for me. I just want to say thank you, Lord.
Lord, I'm grateful unto you for all you've done for me. And I just want to say thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
my heart, oh God. To us, we want to say hello.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. Uwe yedawa se wone wayamaye. Yefri akumen enye kase. Asida enka wudi. Ewe wadi me kafu wo. Wone wayamame. Nye me kare se.
Thank you.